Hi guys, welcome to my game dev diary, my video about the game development. So yeah, I didn't have much time before to focus on the game because I was working, but now I'm back because I wanted to show you something. I didn't just want to make another diary about how I want to make the game. So today I will tell you a little bit what I did and what I'm planning to do. I have designed a character. I guess you guys saw already my YouTube community posts where I have uploaded a few photos of the character. So the character has a few items. It has an axe, it has a pickaxe, and it has, of course, a fishing rod, a few types of hats, and one type of clothing for each part. So a t-shirt, a short pants, pants, and stuff like that. Yeah, I have made all these models in Blender, which is a 3D free software that anyone can pretty much download and use. There is no restrictions or whatsoever, so there are a lot of mods, a lot of different things that you can import into it. And also I'm using it because it's very easy to import anything you make in Blender into Unity 3D software. So yeah, the models that I made are all low poly models, which means that they are not very high definition super looking models, because this is the game design that I want to stick to, the graphics that I want to stick to. I think it has its own feeling to it. I really like all these isometric and low poly game designs, so definitely I'm gonna stick to it. The beards, I made a full beard, I made a middle beard and a small beard, and then also I made like an Italian beard and a square beard and like a few different ones. The hats, I just made a random few designs that you can change. And the backpack, I got a nice tip from Nick, who told me to implement something like a dynamic backpack, which is getting bigger and smaller. So I made a small one now, and then I will make a few stages of the size. And then I will implement a script that will change the model to small and big. Besides that, the beard design you'll be able to change in a barbershop in the game. I think I will implement this kind of place, definitely because I have a beard. Now I wanted to have a basic set of items and models in order to test them in Unity 3D. So I have implemented everything. I have changed only the materials because they are not exactly the same as the ones in Blender. So I had to change that. I will be back into this later. Now I'm just making the basic functions, the basic mechanisms in the game. Like walking, for example, I made a script for the character to walk. So with the arrow keys or with WASD, you can move the character around the map. Besides that, I had to make a few animations, because when you move a character or when the character makes any motion, you have to make an animation. So I made a few just basic ones. For example, walking, standing still. Then I made an animation that is for dying. Also, I made an animation for chopping the wood with an axe. Then also there is, the next animation was pickaxe. And of course I added a fishing related animation. So casting and then pulling back. And there's also an idle set of animations. So for example, when you're standing still and doing nothing, the character is moving. So it looks more real. Besides that, there are idle animations for fishing, because when you cast and when you wait for the fish to catch, the character has to wait a little bit. So I did that, and I already have implemented a script. So everything now in Unity is implemented and connected to each other. So I have a working set of animations that are connected to the character. After that, I have started implementing the mechanism for the casting and fishing. So now I am on a stage where the character throws when it's casting, and the cork that is supposed to stand on the water with use of ray tracing and collision detection is stopping on a surface of water. And that took me about a week or two because it was a little bit confusing for me how it all works, but I have found a way where now it sticks to the surface properly, so I can make different angles of surfaces and it will properly stick into it. So this is the stage that I have done until this week. Additionally, behind me you can see that there's a camera motion. So the Q and E, I guess, the Q and E keys allow you to rotate around the character, and the camera is fixed on the character. So when the character moves, you move together with the camera. So that's really nice, and you can see that it's rotating behind me. Besides that, I have started to implement a basic day and night cycle. So pretty much this is what I have done until now. My goal is to finish probably this month the whole mechanism of fishing. That would include the idle movement of the cork when it's stuck on the water. So it's kind of imitating the movement of the water. After that, of course, I have to catch the fish. So when you get a bite on the hook, the cork should move or go underwater. And that's pretty much what I need to implement now. So as you can see behind me, there's a terrain already created. I have used Blender in order to create this cubic terrain that the character can run around. I have made some boundary colliders, as well as I have used a low polygon mesh shape in order to make it more natural for the character to move. So yeah, this is the first sample map, day and night cycle. There's casting, and the cork attaches to the water surface, like in the videos that I showed. Yeah. Okay guys, so I need to go back to work. If you have any fun ideas, please let me know in the comments. I am talking about this all the time with Nick, and we are exchanging ideas, and I'm making notes about them. But first, this month I have to finish the physics for this game, for this character, in order to properly be able to catch fish. And then I'll start doing fun stuff. Anyway, hope you liked the video. Hope you will support me in making this charity game, hopefully this year. Yeah, and that's it. I'm going back to work. So, peace. And see you next week. So behind me, as you can see, there's a squarish map. Now I have created the collision, terrain, and everything together, and pretty much